Hello and welcome everybody to this tutorial on how to quickly animate speech animations on a character without going too much into detail and letting it animate through the audio file and its amplitude. So I've got the problem at the moment. I have a very short schedule and I have to animate a character who has about 15 to 20 minutes of dialogue, and I got about 3 weeks to do it. I'm alone and I ain't got a library to do stuff like that. So I came up with a plan to use the audio amplitude of the recorded dialogue for the character as a driver for a controller that controls the jaw. It could control more of the lips and so on, and I thought I'd share this idea on how to get this stuff working. So first of all, I want to show you a really quick made example of how you can do it. You, as always, you can put much more effort in it and get it looking far better. Also, I'm not a character animator, I'm more of the all-around technical guy for 3D, so bear with me.
Hello there, this is a speaking test. Hello there, this is a speaking test. Hello there, this is a speaking test.
So as you can see, it's not perfect, but it's moving the jaw in the rhythm of the speech, and for, I guess, some cases of animation, this might be good enough. For the project I'm involved in right now, it's good enough. The first idea to do it was just open mouth, closed mouth, and that looks really shitty, and here we got some individual movement on the jaw. So it's some steps above, but it's not a really good speech animation. But like I said, 15 to 20 minutes in 2 or 3 weeks, no chance there. Okay, let's get started on a new scene. I've got this hat, it's from a past animation project of mine personally. He was the bad guy in my bachelor thesis, and now we ripped his head off to animate it. Okay, you can use any head and you can drive about anything with the technique we're about to use. The only thing you need for this tutorial is the Maya bonus tools. I've got Maya 2012, and the bonus tools can be downloaded via Autodesk. And yeah, we need to activate one of the bonus tools plugins, the so-called AudioWave. So you go to the plugin manager, like I just did, check by the bonus tools line, and check for AudioWave.mll. Check that it's loaded, and I've got an autoload in, because I have to use it at work on my computer there. I'm just showing you this from at home right now, because I wanted to share this nice technique. Alright, let's get started. First we got to rig this head. This is a quick and dirty way to rig this head. Just gonna throw in some joints here. It's not a really good or perfect rig now, it's just to show you how this technique works. As I said before, you can put a lot more effort in it and get far better results out, but now I want to show you how to get there. Okay, I use the join tool. Sorry, when I use one of my custom made shelves, the join tool can be found under skeleton join tool. Alright, now we've got the join set up, we've got a root, we've got a jaw. This can also be a jaw or a mid head, and this is the end head. So we're gonna name these joints. The giant root. Then there's a jaw01, jaw02, goddammit. jaw03 and the end head joint. Alright, now we've got a joint set up. Next thing we want to do is set up some controllers. As we can see here, joints are all in line. As controllers, I just use some curves, drag one around here, that'll be our root controller, null it out. Control main root. Okay, next we need a controller for our jaw, and we need two jaw controllers. And the first one will be driven by our audio input that we are gonna send in later. So what I just saw, we've got 1,000 frames here, that's far too much, 100 should be enough. We created this controller, or this knob circle, and I'm gonna freeze the transformation, or null it first. Then rotate it around 90 degrees. If you press J, you can snap every 15 frames, every 15 degrees while you're rotating it. It's nice to have this. And now we need to snap it to a vertex, or in this case, we want to snap the controller to our joint here. If you press V on your keyboard, hold it and middle mouse drag it, the controller can see it snaps on vertices or our joint here. Now I'm gonna scale it a bit down because it's a control that it shouldn't be touched by hand, but is driven by a script. Alright, now we give it a name, control draw audio driven. Alright. To be very thorough, we give it another color to make it visible that it's not selectable. So I use, like in the naming convention, I use a black color for the circle. And the third and last controller for this tutorial is the controller for the jaw, which we can animate or use later on. So I'm just gonna make it a bit like this, to show it's that it's the mouth. You can take whatever you want, you can use a locate, you can use custom made curves. I'm just gonna use the circles right now. Same thing as before, we rotate it 90 degrees, null it out here, and snap it holding V to our joint, and then drag it out some distance, make it a bit bigger, just to adjust that it's nicer to handle. Size our main controller a bit down. So we will give this also a custom color to make it better visible. Go with a yellow right here. Name it control jaw. Alright, now we take our three controls and first of all delete the history on them. Delete by type, history. And after that we're gonna freeze all the transformations so that they are on null, and we can always get back when we're animating to zero. Freeze transformations, here check that all the transforms are on, freeze transform, and now all of these should be, if we look in the channel box, yeah, should be all zeroed. Okay, now we're gonna start rigging a bit. For that we select the jaw audio driven controller and pull it with the middle mouse button into the jaw controller, so that when we now select the jaw controller, this one, the jaw audio driven controller follows it. but is also, if we select this, individually flexible and movable. And next we select the control jaw and push it into the control main root, same as with the jaw controller. Now all these follow. Next thing to do is select our audio driven jaw controller, so the little one that's directly on the jaw joint. Select this one and select the last jaw joint, these here, and go to constrain, parent, option box on, and yeah, you can reset settings and add the parent constraint. Now our jaw 03 joint follows this audio driven controller. Okay, next step is to skin our head mesh. As with all the other stuff in this tutorial, I'll show how to do it, but I'll do it very rough and not refined. So for that I'll hide the teeth in this guy, that I have full access to the areas inside of the mesh. You select the root joint and select the mesh of the head, or that needs to be skinned, and go check that you have animation selected. Go to skin, go bind skin, smooth bind, and we'll just go with the standard reset settings right now. I'll just switch normalize weights to interactive, because I don't work so good with the post normalization of weights. Bind skin, alright. And if we now take our jaw controller here, something happens, and as we can see, it's not... Oh, yeah, it looks a bit like Ash in Army of Darkness. Yeah, it's not the effect that we want to achieve, so we have to skin a bit. As I said, skinning will be very rough. So select the head mesh, go to skin, edit smooth skin, and paint skin weights tool. Open this and check the attribute editor. Alright, I can see my tool settings for this, so we'll go again, edit smooth skin, paint skin weights tool, and use the option box, and now we got it. So as you can see, here are indicators for the influences, which joint has what of an influence on the different vertices of the mesh. We will go to the root joint, go mode paint, paint operation add, value and opacity both 1, and click flood. So now the root joint has complete control over the mesh, and if you flick through, all others have no input. Then we take the joint jaw 03. Oh, first of all, let's take this controller, go to the channel box, or press Shift and W and Shift E to create a keyframe on the null position, go on the zero position, go to some frames in, move the joint a bit, like, yeah, extreme position that the jaw will never have, and create a new keyframe on this position. And so it's easier for us to apply the paint and the weights and check how it works.